Okay, welcome to a new TechView Vlog, and this time around it's all about unpacking a new vlogging stuff, not for me, but for camera woman behind the camera. And we have a bunch of packages here to unpack, and I will just grab the first one and we'll see what's inside. As you can see, a lot of Chinese writing on top, so it is all bought here in China. And so the first thing that we can see is a microphone arm stand on a flexible boom scissor. So with this you can just put it on your table and yeah, have a microphone attached there, and then you can, like a normal professional on a radio station, talk into your microphone. And yeah, this is a microphone stand. Should we open it up or just show the packaging? I think just show the packaging first, and I put it down here, and then we'll see what's the next thing that we have here. The next thing that we have here is a light ring, LED light ring, I think. This I think I can open up because it's so small and easily foldable. And this is how it looks like. A light ring, so if you want to film yourself in your room and you don't have enough natural light, you can use this. It uses a normal USB plug-in, and you have a remote control here for controlling the intensity of the light. You can turn it on and off, and probably you can also change the colors here, as I was reminded. And it has a nice head as well here, so you can just screw it on a normal tripod, and you can then just simply also with this screw just position it the way you want it, and now it's in a fixed position, for example. So this is a nice thing for lighting. Let's go to the next packaging. Now let's unpack this small thing. It looks interesting. What do we have here? Ooh, here we have another light ring for attachment for the camera with a fisheye camera. No, maybe fisheye, maybe portrait lens. It's a wide angle lens. So super wide angle lens, especially if you want to film yourself and only have one lens on your smartphone. This might be very, very helpful. And of course you have a night light ring as well. So this is the portable, ultra portable vlogging setup if you want to vlog with your smartphone. As you can see here, you can do macro shots with it, so shots like this here, as you can see, very close-up shots, wide angle, and you have a flashlight as well. So you can not only use it as a normal ring light, but you can also use it as flashlight for taking macro photos with your smartphones. And here you can see you have the macro lens and you have a wide angle attachment that you can put on. So two lenses that you can put on this device. So that's not all. We have something else in here, which is a blowing tool for blowing dust off, and as well as a nice little brush here to put the dust away if you have some dust on your lens or on your equipment. So this is also very important and a nice addition to this. So enough of this. And the next one, you can see the pattern of small packages first and the big one last. So this is another interesting packaging with nothing on it. Probably the funny thing is inside. It's a Saramonic vlog mic, so a microphone for vlogging. So if you want to start a vlog, the most important thing is not your video equipment, so your video camera, not so much. You can record just like I do it here with my smartphone. The most important is the microphone, the sound. As you can see here, a cable going. I see it here, a cable going to the smartphone, because the most important thing is the audio quality, because if people cannot understand you, then you cannot bring, you cannot transmit a good content to them. So let's see the Vlog Mic. How does it look like? This is the packaging, fancy packaging. How do you open it? Ah, it's probably magnetic. Yes, of course it is magnetic. People like to do this. Ooh, very exclusive. Here you can see the instruction manual. And it's an omnidirectional microphone, as you can see here. So you can pick up voices from everywhere. And comes with a nice cable, very long cable probably. And a carrying pouch, which is also very handy if you travel. Looks a bit like a carrying pouch for headphones, but inside also a nice little plastic hook. Oh no, it's actually metal. Inside you can find the microphone itself. And not only the microphone, as you can see here, it can be used as omnidirectional microphone, so you can talk from everywhere basically. Or you can use it as directional microphone, talk into here. And of course you have a windshield as well for pop noises and so on that you can put on top if you don't want to have pop noises. And of course this head is also very interesting because you can just simply change the angle of this head. And if you want to plug it in your smartphone, don't have a smartphone right here, do I?
Yeah.
I need the right smartphone here. Have a smartphone with a headphone jack, you can just plug it in here. And if you have an interview situation, you can just simply point it to the direction of your interview, or if you want to take a vlog, point it to, in the direction of your voice or yourself. The cool thing is, by touching, as you can see that this microphone is damped. So this is also very good, especially if you're vlogging and running around. It will not have rattle noises here because it is a damped a microphone, a very small microphone for a smartphone, as you can see here. You can put it in every direction you want to. And yeah, it's a nice little thing. What's here? Silica gel. Ah, and here we have a dead cat as well. Can open this up. Eventually here we have a clamp, because you can of course use this cable, and just like I have a cable here attached to my collar here with the microphone, I can do the same thing with this microphone. I can use this cable, plug it in here, and then I can use one of those clamps inside of this little bag. Can open this up quickly. One of these clamps here, and put it around the microphone like so, and then I can use this clamp to clamp it on top of my collar here on this side, for example. And then of course I can plug it in, and then I have a nice microphone, a lavalier microphone, which is also pretty handy. And the fairy little hat, it's called dead cat because it looks like a dead cat, at least in the English language. And yeah, it's like it has a tightening rubber, and you just put it on top of it. And this is used for if you just go to a very windy place, you can just put it on top of the microphone. And then this dead cat will block the wind noises. So wind coming here, you don't see, you don't hear the wind noises, which is pretty nice and pretty good. Better than this setup here, which is only a pop filter. And this is how it will look like with a wind filter. And you can see sometimes weather reporters also wearing something like this, or they have a stationary microphone with this dead cat on, because of the wind noising capabilities of this dead cat. So very handy, very good vlogging microphone for various different situations, interview situations. Even as I said, it's an omnidirectional microphone. You can use it for interview partners if you have a smartphone with you. You can just use it, plug it in here, and use it as a directional microphone for interview situations, or just hold it like this, or plug it or stand it like this somehow, and then just talk in an interview like situation, which is very, very handy. So this is a top of a notch microphone for vlogging. And yeah,
and it's very cheap.
And it's very cheap, as you might have heard.
Half of the price of the one we saw in the shop.
So it's a very, very... It might be very, very, not very expensive, but good quality, I think. And as you can see here, very big hole for the microphone itself. So the microphone, let's quickly rebox it together with the stuff so I can continue my unboxing. And it's a very nice packaging, hold with magnets as well, as you can see here, so you can store it even somewhere where you want it. So now the biggest thing that we have, it's here, and I think I have to slide it out, if I can slide it out. Okay, empty paper coming first. And almost another empty paper, but there you can see something. Ooh, and this looks like a nice little stand for ring light and smartphone. So what is it? It's a live ring light. So you can use this for attaching your smartphone and have a nice ring light, especially if you want to do vlogging. So another ring light option. And here you can see some of the different usage types that you can, or different scenarios where you can use it. So beauty, vlogging, also for photos you can use it for portraits and so on. Here I think this is a portrait shoot, a selfie portrait shoot in this case with a smartphone. And of course you can use it for vlogging with video stuff. So soft light tech, flicker free, UV free, natural light, no ghosting and no glare is what this thing promises. And of course you have also a remote control to control the light intensity and of course also the color. So another ring light. Now let's see, great unboxing, what's in there. Another little thing here in this package. Let's see, what do we have here? Ooh, here we have clam attachments. These look like clam attachment for smartphones. Two of them. These are necessary, these are necessary for the ring light, so you can put left and right a smartphone there if you want to. And record with multiple smartphones if you want to, but it's also handy to have such attachments. I can open up one quickly to show you how this works. So you have a smartphone like I have here, and what you have to do, and this is, as you can see here, there's this rubber here on the side, and here this Velcro, and what you can do is just simply use this. As you can see, there's a feather inside that's clamming this together. And you can just simply put this smartphone inside here. This rubber will make sure it will not damage the phone. And then here you have a normal screw for a tripod mount. You can screw it in. And then you have a nice stand. You can also screw it in here, which is also nice if you want to screw it in another way. So very handy to have such things for normal tripod. And if you want to record something with your phone. Also very important. Then we have something else in here. Another ring light, live streaming multi-phone holder kit. Actually, this is a multi-phone holder kit. As you can see, you can have multiple phones here that can hold and record stuff. This might be also pretty handy, especially if you have not only phone stuff that you can hold here, but you can have one phone, you can have one holder for your microphone, and you can one phone holder for a ring light or another LED light that you want to attach, or another backup camera or an audio recorder or a battery pack or something else that you can use here to put it on. Live streaming multi-phone holder kit, it's called, and this is how it looked like. as you can see. Yeah, this is this, and that's all. No, there's not more. There's the most important thing. If you want to have a ring light, or in general, if you want to record something awesome, you need to have a tripod of some sorts. And here you can see a nice little tripod that you can use for recording vlogs, as you can see here. Let me unscrew this quickly. This is a tripod, and yeah, as you can see here, a nice little tripod that you can just put on a table like this. And of course, you have a few screws here. You can put a hat on top here, you can put a ring light on top, whatever you want to. And of course, you can make it bigger as well. You can really, really grow it, like if you want something like a ring light from the top, or you want a view from the top. If I'm filming a smartphone or something like that, or a big unboxing like this, and I don't have a camera woman, I can just use this, for example, to film the stuff from the top. And of course, I can loose this screw, and we have a twisted camera woman, professional camera woman, that does not know that my microphone is a bit too short for this. Yeah, and this is, of course, it's not very compact, but usually you don't need to have it such, so it has this size. I've seen more compact ones, but I think this is a solid build in contrast to those other ones. The ones that get a bit more compact, they have more things to twist and turn, and more things that could easily break. And this is more like solid metal, solid aluminium. It will not break so easily. Yeah, I think now everything is empty, and that's it for this little unboxing of a vlog setup. And yeah, we'll see how much of this we will still really use. And tomorrow there will be more, apparently. Okay, so see you tomorrow. Bye. Let's continue unboxing our vlog setup. New packages arrived, a new location here. And yeah, let's start by taking a look at the smallest package that arrived. One essential package, the smallest package at all, but very essential one, memory cards. So you need memory cards to record longer video sessions for your vlog. And so we have two here, 120 gigabytes micro SD memory cards, because we want to use them also on our smartphones to record stuff. And gladly, our smartphones have micro SD card slots. These micro SD cards have, of course, also a rating here, class 10, A1, and U1, UHS1, which is a rating for speed. So you need a very fast card to record stuff for 100 megabytes per second. You can record with this card. This is very important if you want to record 4K video or 1080p video in higher bit rates, like 60 frames per second and higher bit rates. And of course, you can use this card together with an adapter also on your camera if you want to have a normal microSD recording on those SD cards. Yeah, those are very cheap SD cards. So if you buy them here in China, you just pay around 11 euros apparently for each, which is very, very cheap when you compare it to Germany, where you pay around 30, 40 euros for those good SanDisk SD microSD cards, especially microSD cards. SD cards are a bit cheaper, but microSD cards. Yeah, yeah, okay, next one. I'm talking too much about technical specifications, apparently. Okay, 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 next one. Let's go to the next biggest package here, this one, and I can open it up. It wouldn't be a proper unboxing if I wouldn't open it up. And if not, inside of this would be another box to open up. No? But gladly, this is an easy box to open up. And guess what? That's another LED ring light.
Four.
And it has a USB connection apparently. And guess what? I will open this up because I don't know what it is. Be absolutely sure. Why is it so small? Oh, it's a very small one. Oh, this one is for your smartphone to clip on. Apparently, you can clip it on your smartphone with this clip.
Do you have a cell phone with you?
And I don't have a smartphone here to clip it on. But I can show or demonstrate you. Clip it on like this. And you have a micro USB connection here and a cable, and you can connect it for, of course, because there is, I don't think there's a compartment for battery or something. Put it in here. Put it in correctly. And then you can connect it to a light source, a power source, and then you have light on your smartphone. And it is a bit big. Can you put in, the on-off switch is here. And it has a battery apparently inside. So I was wondering if you can put in a battery, but apparently it has a battery inside. So rechargeable battery. So you can change the light here, as you can see, light colors. And you can turn it off as well if you want to. So small little light ring, LED light ring for your smartphone that you can clip on, or you can put it also on the table. You can stand on the table like this eventually.
No.
Not really. You clip it on and stuff on the table and
don't make it up.
You can in theory clip it on stuff. Clip it on your collar or something.
That's so stupid.
You can clip it on stuff to use it. Then the next one, another one. Yeah. So one is not enough, then you can have two. Beauty LED flashlights.
Because
so it's
those
for.
Those are cheap. I'm afraid that will break.
Ah, those are cheap and they could break easily. So this is why my wife bought two.
You take out the other one because they're a different shape, I guess.
It's a different shape, you think? It looks like the same to me. Let's see. Oh, well, this one comes with an instruction manual. I cannot read it, but maybe you can. And yeah, that's it. On-off key, on-off key light ring, and yeah, clip. That's all. The only difference is this is a black one, and this is a white one.
Okay, next one. Let's go.
Okay, that's it for this. Now let's come to the highlight of this show. This big packaging, and I need a little improvised knife slash scissors to open this up. I don't need to show how I'm opening this up. Do I? Is it a proper unboxing if I don't show how to unbox stuff? Because probably, yeah, like I expected, it comes with a packaging on its own. So let's cut through this as well. Get that out of the way. And then we have a few things here. We have a smooth micro USB to LTG lightning adapter. I don't know why. We need this. And we have the highlight of the day. This is a gimbal, a smartphone gimbal. So if you want stable footage, I'm not sure if camerawoman is doing stable footage here. Hopefully the EIS or the super AIS from Huawei is doing its thing. If you don't have a smartphone with a good stabilization, you can use something like this, a gimbal that will stabilize your shot. Not only for this, you can also use it for panorama and various different kind of things and shots. So this is this gimbal. It comes included with several different things, as you can see here, the gimbal itself, then a little tripod, USB cable, of course, because the gimbal itself has, of course, batteries because it needs power. And what's this? I don't know. Maybe we'll open it up and we can see what it is. And there's even more. I didn't notice this. So there's even, if this small little tripod is not enough that comes with the gimbal, you can, of course, use something like this, an extension tripod, where you can put various different things on. As you can see here, a mini tripod, and you can put an extension tube on top. Then you can put on
your camera or your smartphone or various different other things to take shots. Also, here are the measurements, 425 to 1250 millimeters, so 1 meter two in height.
This is sold like 100 euros in Germany.
Yeah, and this gimbal is, I think, 100 euros in Germany. Yeah, and
on
here
Amazon.
On Amazon, you can find this gimbal on Amazon. Probably you've put some links on, so affiliate links if you want to buy it in Germany. You can find it here, there as well. Anime characters as well on top of it. Now let's open it. I'm curious. The highlight of the day, a gimbal. We'll clean up later. So I will break the seal. This is a proper seal, not easily breakable. You just have to cut it. And now, it comes with a very solid packaging, as you can see here. Yeah, let's get out there. Okay, that's this. Here we can find a little booklet. Oops. Hard to open. This is one-time open booklet, apparently. Come on. I think I have to break it a bit. Yeah. With the instruction manual and Android's compatibility with ZI Play. And yeah, instructions manual, how to use the gimbal, how to configure the gimbal and so on, but who needs instructions? But now we have toilet paper. Okay, let's open up the gimbal itself. Here is an opening hole. And here, nicely, neatly packaged, you can find all the accessories and the gimbal itself. So, first of all, the tripod. Let's see, it's a very solid tripod made out of metal, not plastic. Yeah. Can hinge it a bit, different angles if you want to. Go down or very high. Yeah. And I wonder how this works. It's a very, it's a stiff screw, so you don't have a screw to screw it in here. Something like on the side, but you have to screw the whole tripod. Interesting, but very solid. Much more solid than the one that I have usually. Then we have a USB Type-C cable, which is very nice. So it's can be used for your smartphone as well, and it's a very flat cable, as you can see here as well. I like those cables because they don't tingle around so much. So this cable, and then the highlight, the gimbal itself. Oh, it's very light. That's very light. And as you can see, it's powered off right now. It's a lot lighter than I expected, because inside there is also a battery, a very massive battery, because it has to power the gimbal itself. But it can also, and somewhere there's a connection. Yeah, here's a USB-C connection. I think this USB-C connection is not only for charging. It should be able, with this little adapter that we saw earlier here, it should be able with this adapter also to charge smartphones. In this case, I'm not sure why there's a Lightning smartphone. You want to use your iPhone for recording, probably. This is the reason why. We can also get an not only Lightning, USB-C on Lightning adapter, but also USB-C on USB-C adapter, or you can use a USB-C to USB-C cable to charge your smartphone while it is on the gimbal, which is also a pretty nice thing, so you can do recordings. Then you can see here we have a very smooth wheel to perform some actions, and as you can see here, there's a marking as well on the wheel. This can be used for zooming in. If you have if you want to zoom in with your smartphone, or you can use it for fine focusing. So if you want to use manual focusing on your smartphone, you can use this ring as well, which is pretty nice. Yeah. Then we have some buttons and some other controls. Another ring here. for doing something. Like you can see, when I'm rotating this, I can probably turn this, twist this around. And what we want to do now is, let's turn it on, see if it works. Does it have power? Where's the power button? Power button. If you press the power button, it will help. And it turned on, and yeah, it's doing something eventually. But we have to configure this, of course. Here you can see the lights that go on if you turn it on, and they show also, I think, the battery status of your device. Then on the back, you can also find two buttons here with what you can also program something with this as well. And of course, you have buttons here for taking photos, for recording, and for changing the modes for the wheel, and a display button, a menu button as well. And it comes with a software as well for Android and iOS, and you can use it there as well. So big unboxing. I think we will demonstrate stuff also as well after we figured out how to use this. And yeah, that's all for this little unboxing. Hope you enjoyed it. Subscribe, like, and see you next time. Bye.